Do you know what a world scale is? Do you know what is the difference between a fixed differential and a variable differential? Have you ever solved problems on world scale? In this lecture, we'll be looking into these. Hey, what's up? My name is Akash from ShipScope, bringing you the best platform to learn about the commercial shipping subjects. In the previous 9 lectures, we have seen the basics of chartering and we have seen the dry cargo chartering. Now, in this lecture, we are slightly phasing towards the tanker chartering part. The first topic which we're going to cover today is world scale. If you're new here, consider subscribing it at any point of the time. Also, check out the notes and links in the description below. If you like my content, guys, you can always go to my website and get the whole thing downloaded. The whole pack consists of comprehensive lecture slides, which we will be covering right now and which we have already covered. And it even consists of past question papers, solved ICS papers, and my own notes, which will help you to understand this topic very well. So let's get into the lecture, shall we? Hi, guys. Welcome to Chartering 101 by ShipScope. In lecture 10, today, we'll be starting our tanker chartering subjects. The first topic is the world scale. So we'll understand the concepts regarding the world scale, followed by we'll see the theory behind the variable differential and the fixed differentials. Once we have understood the whole theory part, we will be solving some numerical based examples on it. So world scale. World scale is a unified system of establishing payment of freight rate for a given oil tanker cargo. In negotiating a price to pay, it is referred to as WS100. This is how we normally call it, or 100% of the world scale. The actual price negotiation between the ship owner and the charter can range between 1% to 1000, is also referred to respectively as WS1 to WS1000, depending on how much loss the first is willing to take on that voyage and how much the later is willing to pay. Tanker freight rates are expressed in either dollars per ton, lump sum amount, or in world scale. Most of the numerical problems which we will be solving in our upcoming lectures, especially about the tanker voyage estimate, we will take in world scale. WS is an index providing a standard reference marker that allows a comparison across the trade routes. The tanker industry uses this freight rates index as more convenient way of negotiating the freight rates per barrel of the oil transported on many different routes. World scale is the world tanker nominated freight scale and is scheduled of the freight rates applying to the tanker carrying oil in bulk. Nominal means that the freight rates which world scale provided are intended solely as a standard of reference. World scale is available on an yearly subscription basis. It is a joint endeavor of the two non-profit making organizations known as the World Scale Association London and World Scale Association New York. The principal advantage of using World Scale system is that it can greatly simplify the regulation on tanker charters. It's a very easier way. A simple reference in the charter is sufficient to cover all the voyages that are possible within the designated area of that charter. The latest edition of the World Scale contains about 80,000 rates in two sections. The first page covers rate for voyages between one load port and one discharge port, while the other second for the multiple ports. Basis of calculation. Rates per ton for full cargo for a standard vessel are calculated on the basis of the round voyage. Okay, so round voyage means load port, discharge port, and coming back to load port. That is what a round voyage means, okay? And back to the first load port by reference to the vessel of... Now, these are the standard specifications which we take, which is 75,000 deadweight tonnage with speed of 14.5 knots, bunker consumption of 55 tons per day. In addition, for the purpose other than steaming, 100 tons per voyage and 5 tons per port. This is referred to as the standard vessel. So what is the standard vessel under world scale is? This is all the specification are regarding to the standard vessel. The main calculation elements of each rate are fixed jar element of USD 12,000 per day. Bunker cost based on prices over the 6 months ending from 31st March and 30th September. Port time
of 4 days for a voyage from one load port, discharge port plus 12 hours. Each extra port allowed on a voyage and includes lay time of 72 hours for the purpose of loading and discharging. These are the standard calculation which we take. Canal transits time at the rate 24 hours each transit of Panama Canal and 30 hours for each transit of Suez. True world scale facilitates swift negotiation can occur. The world scale comes very, very handy when you do the negotiation. However, it is only a datum and not a substitute for a voyage estimate. Neither does it offers any protection against financial risk. An owner will need to make his own assessment of the likely cost involved on a voyage, decide whether or not the levels of the world scale on offer for a particular piece of business has any attractions. If there are any particular expenses that the owner feels are not dealt under the world scale, he can negotiate expenses with the charterer. I've provided you a link, so you can always go to the website and get the information on preamble, history, company structure, what are the policies, so you can go into the official website and check it by yourself. Now, what is a variable differential? We have two differentials here. One is variable and we have fixed differential. Variable differential. These usually apply where the port charges on a given ship will be assessed differently depending upon whether she is carrying products or crude, or whether she is loading or discharging. That is how the variable differential comes into play. And so it is easier for these differences to be tackled just on one page of the schedule part of the market rate level agreed. Variable rate differentials are added to or deducted from the applicable rate of freight. Such variable rate differentials are subjected to the percentage variation which the contracting parties have agreed to apply to the Wolski rate. Now, this is fixed differential. Differentials to be included as a part of freight payments as fixed amount. These are the fixed amount in respect of cost incurred by the owners. Such differentials are not subjected to any percentage variation which the contracting parties have agreed to apply the to world scale rates. Fixed differential apply where the port costs vary due to some levies or tubes, which are calculated irrespective of the amount of voyage cargo loaded. Calculation. Now, before we hit into the calculation, I would like you guys to request that you can take out your calculators and a piece of pen and a paper. So the first question, it's an easy one. We need to calculate the total freight. The load port given is Fujairah. Discharge port is Sikka. Total quantity to be carried is 80,000 metric tons. Freight rate is WS 75. WS 100 flat rate is given as per the question is 7.09 per metric ton. So in order to calculate the answer, first we know that in order to calculate the freight, it's basically quantity multiplied by freight payment. Freight fixed is WS 75. This is on which the freight is fixed. The first thing we need to do is we need to convert this into WS 75. WS 100 is given as 7.09. If we multiply that figure with 4.75 or 75 divided by 100, we get the rate at WS 75, which is 5.3175 per metric ton. So we use WS 75 as 5.3175. This is the freight rate on which the vessel is fixed on. When you multiply this now, WS 75 with 80,000 metric tons, we get our total freight is 425,400. That is how we calculate the total freight. Let's look at the calculation number two. This is a bit tougher. We have a vessel name called motor tanker Athena. Load port is Saint Petersburg, Russia. Discharge port is Rotterdam. Minimum cargo quantity to be carried is 100,000 metric ton. Freight is WS 70, additionally, which is a 50%. BL quantity. Now, what was loaded? Minimum quantity was 100,000, but actual figures which were loaded were 104,000. 104,000. That means 4,000 excess compared to the minimum quantity. WS100 given is, which is called as flat rate, is given as USD 10.94 metric per metric ton. Please calculate freight for the total loaded quantity. In order to calculate the freight, we need to multiply the freight rate multiplied by the total quantity carried. That is the basic concept. But since in this question, this is the catch. If they are asked 50% OA on WS70, what that means is, first, let's write down the question. We have freight rate as WS70. Flat rate WS100 is USD 10.94 per metric ton for voyage from St. Petersburg to Rotterdam. This is what is flat rate, which is given. Rate at WS70, 10.94 multiplied. In order to convert this WS100 into WS70, we have to multiply it by 0.7, or 70 divided by 100, which gives us the rate at WS70. So it gets reduced to 7.658 per metric ton. The total freight, as per the minimum quantity to be carried, is 100,000 metric tons multiplied by that amount, which is your 7.658 metric ton. We get this figure. The second thing, the excess figure, which is we have loaded the BL can quantity loaded, was 104,000. So the 4,000, which is excess, needs to get multiplied with the WS70 figure on 50%. That is what it means. So if you see here, 4,000 metric ton multiplied by WS70 multiplied by the 50% of that gives you this amount. Now all you have to do is add these figures, and once you add these figures, the total freight comes out to be 781,116. This is what the total freight for this calculation is. Let's look at a big difficult problem now. It's a bit tricky with calculation number 3, the last sum. Calculation number 3, vessel empty style. Load port is Kirk Island, Iran. Discharge port is Ulsan, SBM number 1. This is the berth. Minimum quantity to be carried is 200,000 metric ton. Now, again, if you see, this is a very tricky part. WS50. Additionally, on 50% up to 240,000 metric tons. OA, 25% for the quantity above the 240,000 metric tons. What is the actual BL quantity which was loaded was 261, which is above the 240, which is 261,400 metric ton. Flat rate, as per WS100, is given as USD 23.66 metric ton. Now, in this question, we will be using the fixed rate differential and we will be using the variable rate differential. For loading at any port in Iran, fixed rate differential is given as 0.22 per metric ton on loaded quantity to be added. The question is specifying the fixed rate differential to be added. Now, in case of variable rate differential, for the cargo operation at Ulsan, variable rate differential of USD 0.22 to be deducted. That means it is supposed to be subtracted from the WS published rate. Please calculate the freight for the total loaded quantity. I would like you guys to take a snapshot if you have, because now the next page is going to be the solution. Freight fixed is at WS50. As you see, WS50. Flat rate is given as WS100 as USD 23.66 per metric ton for voyage from Kharg to Ulsan. First, we need to subtract the variable rate differential, which is 0.22 per metric ton. So we minus 23.66 with 0.22, and we get USD as 23.44 per metric ton. Now, in order to convert this figure into WS50, we need to multiply it by 0.5, which is 50 divided by 100, and we get the WS rate, which is $11.72. Rate at WS50 becomes this 11.72 per metric ton. Now, total freight. The first thing is 200,000 metric ton multiplied by the 11.72. This is the first one you need to calculate. You get this figure. Now, anything excess 200 till 40 was given as per 50%. If you see the question, WS50 up to 240,000. The minimum quantity was 200,000. You multiply that figure with WS50. Anything which is above 200 to 240 will multiply with by the WS50 plus into multiplied by 50%. And anything above 240 till 261 will be multiplied with the 25% too. Coming back to the question, we get 40 multiplied by the 11.72 into 50. This is the second one. Thirdly, which is the quantity which is loaded above 240 is 21,400 metric ton. Multiply that figure with 11.72 multiplied by the 25%, we get the 62,702. Differential, freight rate of 0.22 on quantity to be loaded. This is your fixed differential. In order to do this, we need to multiply the whole amount with the 0.22 and you get the figure as 57,508. Now, in order to get the whole freight, we need to add A, B, C, and D. Finally, the total freight which we get is 2698,610,00. With this, we finish off the lecture number 10. I hope you understood it.
Since we have finished our 10th lecture, I would like to hear out from you guys if you have any queries in the comment section below. If you like my video, hit the like button. And always remember, guys, some of the most important tips and feedbacks come from you. So feel free to connect me on LinkedIn. Thanks for checking out the video. Subscribe if you haven't already. In the next lecture, we're going to see Tanker Charter Party and its relevant clauses. Until next time, ShipScope is bringing you the best platform to learn about the commercial shipping subjects. Keep on learning it, and we will talk soon.